I am Deeksha Jain and I have cleared civil services examination with 22nd rank in the 2019 results, and I have done with my optional English literature. And this video is going to be all about why one should take English literature and how to prepare for it. Now the first question, why literature? So I would say the only reason that a person should take literature is because they are interested in it and they have some kind of liking for it. I personally was in love with literature. My graduation and post-graduation was also there and was also done in English literature. So I was fairly confident about it as well. Now, if you love a subject, then what happens is that the effort that you have to put for it does not make you sweat, or it does not, you know, affect you that much. So one beautiful thing that happened because I took English literature was that 4 days, 5 days I would study GS and then I would get tired of it. Then I would just pick up a novel or pick up a poet and read. And that would be like, you know, it would be so enjoyable that after 6 days, it would have been like, you know, I can still claim that I've been studying, you know, non-stop for the entire week and at the same time enjoying myself. Now, the second thing is that should you take literature if you don't have a background in it? Now, personally, I had a background, but I know seniors, in fact, two seniors who did not have a background in English literature and they have done very well in the exam. One is my mentor, Mr. Gaurav Garg sir, and he's currently in the IRS. And second is, I think last year, Ms. Anjali S. ma'am, she cleared with English literature and she's in the foreign services. I would say that if you're interested in it, then whether you have a background in it or not really doesn't make a difference. You just need to know how to approach the examination. Now, the first and the foremost thing is that you have to read all the texts. What people sometimes do is that they will skip reading a novel and just go to the summary, and that really takes out the depth out of the entire subject. That is the fun element of the subject. So reading the core text is very important. Now, I will be honest with you. There were a couple of texts. I think there was one text which I could not completely read. And I read, I think, 3/4 of it, and I sort of also Googled a summary. But I did not even attempt a question on it, because, I mean, you can maybe do that with one text, maybe. But then otherwise, you have to read the entire syllabus. That is very important. And people think that in literature, critics are important, what others have had to say about their text. But actually, what is really important is your own understanding of the text. How you analyze the text is going to be your answer. Maybe if you read a few critics, you can quote them here and there, but that is not the mainstay of your answer. Your answer is basically your understanding of the text. And unless you read the text properly and you read it on your own, your understanding will not be able to develop. So if a person loves literature, they will not mind reading the text. So I would say, first point, read the text. Second point, note down interesting quotations from the text which you found were, you know, which attracted you. This can be a very fruitful process, because one, you will be noting down things from the text, and that will help you in, you know, sort of, it will rekindle your memory. And secondly, these quotations have to be used in the answer. The more you quote in the answer, the more beautiful it is and the more sense it makes. See, in a literature answer, the pattern is like this. They will ask you a question. For example, maybe they will ask you a feminist reading of Jane Austen. And what you will do is that you will introduce the text. Then you will start making your point that, supposing, why is Jane Austen a feminist writer? Why is Pride and Prejudice a feminist novel, for example? So maybe you will say that the character of Elizabeth, the way, you know, she's interested in reading, she has her own identity. She does not want to go into that trap of, you know, marrying for money, and she is, you know, a romantic at heart. And these things have really inspired the feminist movement. But if you say these same things and you give a quote from the text to substantiate it, that really makes the answer beautiful. And you know, the quotations don't have to be like very big. They can be just three word sentences. For example, in Huckleberry Finn, what is the changing point of Huckleberry Finn's life and the central ideological aspect of that book is contained in the following lines, basically, which are, all right then, I'll go to hell. So it is basically this which, you know, is going to enhance your answers. So please don't be scared by quotations. Love them, and you know, you note them down, you read them in your free time, you know, throw them at people, in conversations, you know, you will start using them in answers, and that will make a lot of difference. Coming to the next point is answer writing. See, now those of us who have done graduation, post-graduation or any kind of studies in literature, we have been writing 8-page long answers, 6-page long answers. UPSC does not give you that much time. I will tell you this, the questions that you got in university are the ones which are you are going to get in the optional paper. But the amount of space and time that you will get for the same question is going to be very less. So what do? You practice writing the same answers, the same point in a very succinct and concise manner. And how does that happen? It happens like this. You put the timer. If it is a 10-mark question, for example, you put a 7-minute timer. If it's a 15-mark question, I've forgotten, I think it's 12 minutes or something like that, or 14 minutes. And you write within that timer. And you will write, the first answer, you might feel like, oh my God, this is so bad. But then the more you write, the more you will improve. You will realize the importance of precise writing. And you will understand how fewer words are to be used. When in an answer, you're making an argument, you're making one single point, you give one single very effective evidence, but you don't have to give like 3-4 evidence like we used to do in university. That really reduces the length of the answer. And with quotation and precise writing and practicing answer writing, English literature is really a cakewalk. Now, how will you revise and how will you, English literature syllabus is supposed to be very vast. There are so many novels, so many poets, so how do you consolidate it? So now the thing is, because they are all stories and poems, you won't have a hard time remembering it. It will be ingrained in your blood if you've, read it properly. What you can do is that now all these quotations that you have noted, apart from that, what you can do is that maybe if you find some good introductions, you can, read them. And if you find any important lines, you can note them down in one place. You can also, what you can also do is that your own understanding of that text. Write a few lines, write a few like 5-6 points. Okay, so if this question comes, then I'm going to, like, my understanding is this, that I want to write these points. And when you consolidate this material, you will have like a 4-5 page handout. The first page has to be the previous year questions that have been asked from that particular text. All the other pages are your understanding of those questions and the important quotations from the text. And what will happen is that when you are revising before the examination, you will have these small handouts, and it will be very easy for you to consolidate your entire learning, and you will be able to reproduce it beautifully in the examination. Please focus on reproducing the quotations, on using critics wherever possible, wherever you have read, and on writing, a little beautifully. There should be flow in the answer. One paragraph should be connected with the other. The introduction should be emphatic. The conclusion should also be, summing up things. It should put an end to the argument. Now, it all sounds very beautiful when you say it like this, but really the way to it is practice. Practice and practice with a timer, I would say. And it will work out beautifully. I have personally always believed that if literature is done properly, and if you follow whatever I'm saying right now, and most of this guidance has been given to me by Gaurav sir only, for which I'm really thankful to him, then it is very easy to crack this exam, and it will be an enjoyable journey, and you will, every other paper you will forget, but your literature paper you will always remember, and it will be a beautiful feeling to give that paper also. So I would just say this, that enjoy, again it's like a revision, enjoy the text, read the core text, even if you don't read anything else, it is completely alright. Please write and write a lot, and use quotations, learn quotations and reproduce them in your answers. And I'm sure it will be wonderful. Please don't be scared by this optional. It's a wonderful, wonderful optional, and you will really enjoy it. Thank you so much. And I'm happy that I'm doing this talk today, because again, like, this is something I'm doing for literature, and it makes me very glad.